back to the Daily Poem here in the Close Reads Podcast Network. I'm David Kern. Today's poem is by a Welsh poet, Dylan Thomas, who lived from 1914 to 1953. It's his most famous work. It's called Do Not Go Gentle Into That Good Night. Frankly, I'm a little surprised I haven't read this poem yet on this show, but it's high time, so we'll go ahead and read this one for this week. In his anthology, The Classic 100 Poems, William Harmon writes, quote, Thomas belonged in a great tradition that includes William Blake, John Keats, Thomas Hardy, Gerard Manley Hopkins, and William Butler Yeats, poets who sang ecstatically and wisely of birth, love, death, and glory. So this is Do Not Go Gentle Into That Good Night by Dylan Thomas. Do not go gentle into that good night. Old age should burn and rave at close of day. Rage, rage against the dying of the light. Though wise men at their end know dark is right, because their words had forked no lightning, they do not go gentle into that good night. Good men, the last wave by, crying how bright their frail deeds might have danced in a green bay. Rage, rage against the dying of the light. Wild men, who caught and sang the sun in flight and learned too late they grieved it on its way. Do not go gentle into that good night. Grave men near death, who see with blinding sight, blind eyes could blaze like meteors and be gay. Rage, rage against the dying of the light. And you, my father, there on the sad height, curse, bless me now with your fierce tears, I pray. Do not go gentle into that good night. Rage, rage against the dying of the light. Harmon mentions in the introduction to this poem and in the anthology that Dylan Thomas's popularity coincided with the invention of the long-playing phonograph record. And that one of the reasons that Thomas became as popular as he did, his career flourished as much as it did, was because he was an excellent performer, that he was the best performer and speaker and reader of any of the modern poets. That's what William Harmon claims. And this is a poem that I think probably reveals Dylan Thomas's sense of performance. I read it a little bit more neutrally, as I somewhat tend to do on this show, but you can see how he would get up there and he would perform this with great gusto, almost like a monologue. This is a villanelle. If you don't know what that is, it's fairly simple. It's a 19-line poem. It's always 19 lines with two rhymes throughout. It consists of five tercets and a quatrain, with the first and third lines of the opening tercet recurring alternately at the end of the other tercets, and with both repeated at the close of the concluding quatrain. So 19-line poems with five three-line stanzas and then a four-line stanza. So you'll notice the opening stanza is, do not go gentle into that good night. Old age should burn and rave at close of day. Rage, rage against the dying of the light. So that do not go gentle into that good night line is repeated at the end of stanza two and four, and then the third line of the quatrain, and then the rage, rage against the dying of the light is the third and fifth stanzas, and then also the last line of the quatrain at the end. So that's a quick overview. You can go look at it, obviously, and see how that plays out, but it's certainly one of the most famous villanelles. And I think that one of the things that makes this poem work and makes it so popular and makes it so memorizable, and which makes it so performable, as Harmon is alluding to, is that it employs that form, that villanelle form, in a really dramatic and precise way. And that's one of the reasons why it's one of the most well-known and most imitated villanelles. It was published in 1952, probably written in 1951, and was written to Dylan Thomas's own father, who was dying, and that poem makes that pretty clear. But Thomas himself died pretty young. He died at age 39, and his own life was pretty dramatic. He endured quite a bit, and also was forced to endure a lot that he put himself through in his marriage, in his intellectual life, in his creative life, in his social life. And in some ways, I think this is a poem that perhaps responds to that. That is, it's about the idea that there might be more honor in refusing to accept your fate, I think is how William Harmon puts it. Rather than just sort of acquiescing and giving in to what seems to be coming to you. It's not a unique theme throughout poetry, but the formal dramatic aspect of that reminds me of something like a Henry V speech. you know, one of those great historical speeches that a king or a soldier would give on a bridge or on a horse or something like that to rouse his men to battle. And in some ways, it seems as if he's offering that to himself. He's trying to push himself onward. But that attempt to be rousing and inspiring comes out clearly, and when you look at the form of the poem as well, in each stanza, he could be either talking to or describing good men, wild men, grave men. So good men rage against the dying of the light. That could be a description of good men, but it could also be a calling to, you know, a cry to good men. Wild men do not go gentle into that good night. It could be a description and also a cry out to them, a pleading. There's so much suggestiveness in that, and I think that's what makes this poem particularly stand out. So here is, "Do not go gentle into that good night," one more time. "Do not go gentle into that good night. Old age should burn and rave at close of day. Rage, rage against the dying of the light. Though wise men at their end know dark is right, because their words had forked no lightning, they do not go gentle into that good night. Good men, the last wave by, crying how bright their frail deeds might have danced in a green bay, rage, rage against the dying of the light. Wild men, who caught and sang the sun in flight, and learned too late they grieved it on its way, do not go gentle into that good night. Grave men, near death, who see with blinding sight, blind eyes could blaze like meteors and be gay, rage, rage against the dying of the light. And you, my father, there on the sad height, curse, bless me now with your fierce tears, I pray. Do not go gentle into that good night. Rage, rage against the dying of the light." This has been The Daily Poem. Thanks for listening. Be back tomorrow with another poem.